Yeah, I like the redesign. Huh, this is where, I wonder what train this is. It won't stop. Do you know what this is? It might be that Montgomery train. But it's already passed, though. That wouldn't make any sense at all. So they just have to slow down, because you are approaching a station. You don't want to fly through here at high speed. Especially with people walking that close to the platform. It's a slightly crumpled map, but it's kind of unique here. You got the layout of the map, and I guess the mall is behind you. I don't know what it's called, but I'm sure I'll correct any annotations. Then they show the platform level. BART is on the lowest platform, Muni is on the mid platform, and then you have the concourse level, which is where we're at right now. Over here is a map of busboarding locations on the local streets. So that's kind of interesting there. And over here, you can see some of the colors are kind of faded. That red faded down to dullish orange, but that shows the local area and the cable car. Then a larger view of San Francisco. Very unique there. Over here, they got full detailed directions on how to use the BART system. And they show the lines, and they show how to get on board and how to find your train, board the correct train. And, you know, being fair, respectful, all that. You got a Golden Gate Trans and Sam Trans. San Francisco Muni here. I hear Muni right below me. Then you've got another map of the system and the rules and requirements. Pretty simple, yes. So the Powell Street Station is unique. You have the BART entrances on this side. You got your ticket machines over here. And you got the Muni on that end. And then behind me, I'm going to slow it down over. Well, not slowly, but that's the West Coast San Francisco Center. I'm going to go explore for a while. And then here's the train schedules for BART. And this one is much more complex to read than the one I showed in San Francisco, because you got four lines for Daly City and Millbrae. You got one for Richmond, you got one for Fremont, one for Dolan Plus, and then one for Pittsburgh Red Point. So yeah, reading it really does help. Of course, it's great to have a handle pamphlet, but when you're at a station, these can also be up to date. Right. Here's an ad fare machine. So if your ticket doesn't have enough when you get off, you just bring it here and add tickets or add money. And then here's the rough fare from the station itself, one way round trip, which you can also use on a pamphlet. And this is what my aunt was talking to me. Tickets and magnets don't mix, so try to keep it away from your mobile phones and anything magnetic. Otherwise, you'll have to see the attendant and have them fix it. Four-car Fremont train is approaching now. Here's Powell Street Station. We're over here on platform 2. Nothing's going to be arriving on platform 1 in time, because I'm going to get on the Richmond train and go back to downtown Oakland. The Embarcadero, Montgomery, Powell, and Civic Center stations are all 1 minute apart. So you can probably see the train down there. If I had a really good zooming lens, I could show it to you, but this is good enough. So it is a 4-car train, so it's going to board in the center. Move away from the flat slightly. All right, down there. Got a nice view of the approach. Probably a nice bound train. So this is the green line. You can tell it's the green line for sure. Rush hour commute over, they don't need 10 cars anymore, but the Fremont Daly City line typically never had 10 cars. So I guess we're going to, unless you want to wait longer, I can wait longer, not a problem. Because the Richmond train is in 2 minutes, I can capture some more departures. Dome Plus 2 is in 8 minutes. And then I can get on a Pittsburgh Point in 10 minutes, so I guess I'll probably wait for the Pittsburgh Point train. 5-car Richmond train, probably the Millbrae line as well. Well, actually, it is the Millbrae line, so the red line, but they never use red or color denotions for here. Then there's going to be a Daly City train approaching on the opposite platform that we're going to try and capture. City train approaching the opposite platform now. hours, so no problems here. Car Delta City Train. I'm gonna move over to the other side now and capture it. It's coming in from Montgomery. It's a four car, so it's gonna be right in the center here. The Richmond train is taking off. That one had an A car. I don't know where this one could have come from. Four cars, it most likely came from Fremont. Pretty easy. I'm staying far enough away from the Daktronic sign at platform 1 so you can read it much clearer than I did before. If you stand too close, my flip shutter speed will kill it. At least the daily shutter speed. It could be stability as well. With the old Sonys, I shut off steady shot and it wouldn't have foam. Not gonna do it now. Just stand far enough away. 40th anniversary of BART. Always my favorite system. But you can see the next train approaching. That's the Federal Airport 5 car approaching from Montgomery, so it's slightly downhill down there. It's a 5 car board center. It definitely came from Pittsburg point. It could have been that special Montgomery train too. They cut the train in half. I'll put a link in all my descriptions for BART fans, but he does really good at tracking all this, better than me. I'll never track as well as him. Very cool. Battery's definitely not lasting as long as normal because I'm starting and stopping and powering it on and off all the time. If I do straight recording, it'll last longer. So I'll watch this one leave. Double plus two trains could be on the other side, so along with a Millbridge train on this side, so I'm probably going to stand here and capture them both. Civic Center. The sign's pretty clear and easy to read, which is what I like about the system. There's a 5-car Millbridge train coming up now on platform 1. I like these Powell Street signs. I think they should do that more. One black text on white contrast better than white text on black. And the double plus two trains coming up on the other end. Ooh, they have an A car on this one. I love the A cars, if you couldn't already tell by now. So I'll move the over towards the middle so I can capture both. I'm avoiding the double plus 10 four cars board center. If you missed the double plus train, you can always take a Fremont one. That way you don't have to wait the full 15 minutes. But you'll have to transfer to Bayfair. They usually have synchronized timing, but since you're taking a Fremont bound train from San Francisco and not from Richmond, the timing's gonna be different. Wow, the double plus train got there first, or second, and they're already leaving. This is definitely better than when I used that old Sony tape camera. The Millbridge train is still there. Daily City train 4 car in 4 minutes. San Francisco Airport 5 car in 9 minutes. Fremont train 5 car in 7 minutes. We got Daily City in 4 minutes, yeah. So you got a Pittsburgh point in 2 minutes, so that's the train I'm going to get on now. So we'll capture it in a few minutes. Here comes the 9-car Pittsburgh point train that I'm going to get on now. They're coming up from a hill slightly over from Civic Center. So it's not just flat linear, even though you're in a city. Could be the way they built it, but you never know. I hear Muni above us. That's a flat B or C car. Woo! Wind draft. Cool stuff. should be able to see IA in the distance over there. I'm on kind of my left. And you can see the MacArthur Maze interchange over there. I'm not going to be touring IA on this trip. I don't really have a need to because Brett did an awesome job with it. So, oh, there's a train there. Short one, but yeah. Nice view of Berkeley and Emeryville and all that. You pan over and then you see, this is the improved section of the freeway, so it's much nicer than this stuff south of downtown Oakland. Here's the post office center. Wow, look at those trucks. So the second view of downtown Oakland. I think we're good for now. AA goes over and under the BART tracks. And I think it was around here where they had that fire on the track that damaged the system. So yeah, here's the West Oakland BART station. I'll move over so I can show you guys downtown Oakland for a little bit.
There's a very nice view downtown Oakland, and we're going to take off inside.
First car, so I can get out quickly. And from here, you can, at the 19th Street Station, you can quickly transfer to a Richmond train from the Fremont line.
Yeah, it was right here that they had the damaged tracks. They did a test run after they repaired it to see if it was functional, and it was.
Mile 13. Up there's another BART train. This is the problem. When you have four tracks or four lines superimposed on one, you're going to get a lot of runover. So we're going underneath the new improved section of IE. Well, not new and improved, this happened in 99. But it's holding up quite well.
There's a street sign down there, 80 South San Jose. You can see it's a major trucking corridor from the Port of Oakland, especially.
Broadway, Alameda. That's those twin towers of the federal building, but I'm not sure exactly. But there's an ask.com main building. There's Marriott, prison. Well, I'm not sure you guys want to hear about prisons.
More of the ports and shipping cranes over there through the glass.
We're slowing down a little bit because of the tracking difference.
In order to ensure that Richmond, or the double Pleasanton lines and Fremont lines go away from the Pittsburgh Great Point Richmond lines. I may tour this at night. No, I don't do it during the day. I know Brent had a great video of night. I'm going to try and make mine a little bit different, obviously. I'll probably do 880 North at night. But again, it's going to depend on my timing. We're coming to a halt here. In a moment, I'll show you guys where the segmented line occurs. And then you see the 90 west flyover ramp to 80 south. We're descending down now. You can see where there are separating track lines. And then the other lines are going to the right, so we're in the center. I don't think you can see, but you should be able to see the tunnel up ahead. Yeah, you see the tunnel to the right, and there's another train coming.
Alright, great. The next Pittsburgh Great Point train is 15 minutes out. It's not a time transfer because it's no longer a transfer station. We've got the Richmond train over here. Let me see if I can rush over and see it. It's a three car because there's no longer peak hours. So yeah, it's all the way down there. That one obviously came from Fremont. That one did not come from San Francisco at all. Very short three car. They have a time transfer at 19th Street. Ooh, an A car. And just like I ended my previous one, I'm ending it here. Hope you guys had an awesome time viewing these BART compilations. Maybe I'll do more in the future, of course, without a doubt. But of course, check out BART Fans, man. He does a great job at it. So, catch you guys later. So we're right here in the heart of San Francisco. That's Powell Market Street. Meeting car. Going that way. I'm just going to take still pictures off my phone, off this. I'm not going to waste time breaking out my phone and just taking photos here and there. Cable car's taking off. But there's another one approaching. I'll try and get video of it turning around. I live in a really cool city. There's a metro over there. Got some buildings down the street. That's the original. Ooh, let's take a look at that. Andres Pelline, dedicated to the Cable Street Railway in 1873. That looks like an original cable car lot. They have those mini buses down there, and living bathrooms right there. So yeah, I personally am not a big fan of driving down here, but exploring it on foot is pretty cool. Long time to explore it all, but you know, you appreciate what you don't have anymore. You have the malls there. I think it's called Westfield San Francisco Center. That's what I saw there. I'll actually sit through the BART station later. Let's watch these bad boys turn that cable car around. You're not going to get as big as the view as I'd like, but it's better than nothing. The iconic cable cars of San Francisco. Very cool. You got a line already stretching towards that end there. And of course other people wanting to film it too. They turn around and I think they just push it forward. I don't think engines drive that. I think it's pulled by cable underground. This is the Powell and Mason Street. One, I think this is the one that takes you to the takes you to Fisherman's Wharf. There might be more. You got the handlebar lever lock. Then he's gonna lock it. Lock. And then they're gonna load. And then you got yet another one down there. I think that's a different one. That might be Powell and Hyde. That would be a smart thing if they alternated. He's gotta ring his bell and load up. I'm not sure how you pay again. I think you pay that conductor, but oh well.